I'm Lera Shemwell. I grew up in this church. I am a regular attendant of the Saturday night service. And in this sermon series about money, I would like to offer a few thoughts. As Christians, we know that everything we have is a blessing from God. It is God's universe. We are riding on God's earth, and we are God's people. God has entrusted us with the care of this earth. God has also entrusted us with the care of God's money. As the entrusted owner, how do you make God's money be all that it can be? First, I'd like to say what money is not. It cannot be a good laugh or a warm hug. It is not a sunset or a waterfall. It is not a child, your grandmother, or your best friend. It cannot save you or justify your sin. But earned ethically and used properly, it can be an inheritance in the kingdom of God. The Bible tells us that earning ethically is essential to pleasing God and avoiding sin. Ill-gotten treasures have no lasting value, but righteousness delivers from death. That's Proverbs 10:2. Also from Proverbs, the Lord detests the use of dishonest scales, but he delights in accurate weights. Money needs to know your love of God is first, last, and always. When that is true, the money God has entrusted to you can heal others. It can become a joyful hug from your neighbor. It can bring the sunlight of God's love to a dark place. It can shelter, feed, bathe, and clothe the pure. It can help you love your neighbor and the world more fully. Generosity can show your love of God to all of your neighbors. In fact, mastery of money reflects your love of God. Our neighbors are suffering from fires, tornadoes, hurricanes, flooding. We are suffering from a national health crisis, the loss of loved ones, the loss of jobs, and worries about children and their education, and the loss of our normal congregate worship. As the entrusted owners, how will you put God's money to work? Amen.